General Secretary of the All India Defence Employees Federation. In a brief, I would like to give a background. In the same office where Guru Sahib is sitting, on 21-8-2019, when we were in the midst of a one-month strike, the then CAWC, Mr. Verma, called us for a dialogue in which Joint Secretary Ordnance Factory was present. Today only the director is present, Joint Secretary is not present, no problem. He represents ultimately Secretary D.P. Jain Sahib, isliye aapko usme koi complaint nahi hai. On that 21st, you please go through the minutes of that meeting, which is recorded by DLWC Verma ji, in which all of us are signatories. The Department of Defense Production is a party, federations are party. Now, on the basis of the agreement reached on 21-8-2019, the last para of the minute says that whatever settlement is reached with the government, the office bearers of the federations and the Ministry of Defense have to inform to you, right? On that basis, 23-8-2019, Dr. Ajay Kumar, the then Secretary DP, called the three federations for a dialogue. You please go through the minutes of that meeting also, in which it is clearly recorded. He has given a message to the federations, the government of India has not taken any decision to corporatize the ordnance factories. This is verbatim recorded in the minutes. The government of India has not taken any decision to corporatize the ordnance factories, that is number one. Number two, the concerns, the difficulties, the proposals, whatever the federations are having, a high-level official committee will be constituted and the federations should appear before the committee and speak to them so that a mutual settlement can be reached. On the basis of that agreement, we have deferred the strike. On 24th August 2019, we have written to Secretary DP that on this basis, we are deferring our one-month strike. After 5-day strike, we have deferred. Copy we have endorsed to the office of the CLWC or your Chief Labour Commissioner also. But whether Ministry has given you any report, we are not aware of that. So this is the second thing. 21st meeting in your office, 23rd agreement with the government, 24th we have deferred the strike. And the government has constituted high-level official committee with Additional Secretary DP as the chairman. There is a dispute in the terms of reference of the committee between the federations and the government of India. We are repeatedly submitting representations to the government that these terms of reference, whatever you have given to the HLOC, is not acceptable to the federation. That has to be changed. Unless that is changed, we are not in a position to continue in the meetings of the HLOC. This is where the position stands, Guru Sahib. Now, on 16th May 2020, when an industrial dispute negotiation is pending before the Department of Defense Production, based on a written agreement reached under the chairmanship of the Chief Labour Commissioner is pending. You may please take a note of it. This negotiation discussion is pending before the government. It has not come to its natural conclusion. But in violation of that, on 16-5-2020, the Honorable Finance Minister is coming before the public and in the name of COVID-19 relief, the Finance Minister has announced Ordnance Factory Board is going to be corporatized and it will be listed in the share market. Is it not an unfair labor practice? Is it not an illegal action on the part of the government when an industrial dispute settlement reached before the CLC, when the negotiations are pending with the government of India, when the Secretary DP has given in writing that government of India has not taken to corporatize the ordnance factories, you please withdraw the strike. On the basis of that assurance, we have deferred the strike. That negotiation is pending. And government has come to the conclusion. Immediately after that, sir, on 16th this announcement came, 17th onwards, at least till date, 17 representations the federations have submitted to the President of India, who is the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, the Honorable Prime Minister, Raksha Mantri, and the Secretary DP, and we have written to your good self also. No reply, no this thing. Nobody bothered for our representation, and the cabinet has taken a decision. Ordnance factory will be corporatized. We have protested. The cabinet took a decision, empowered a group of ministers committee. We have protested. The government has decided a consultant, and against the consultant appointment, there are already 2 CVC complaints pending before the government. With all these things, left with no other option. No other option, since nobody bothered in the ministry to listen to the genuine grievance of 80,000 employees who are recruited as central government employees either through UPSC or through an All India entrance examination. You have not bothered about their service matters. They will lose their status as a government employee. They will lose their status as a defense civilian employee. There are so many Supreme Court judgments that you cannot change the employer. You cannot change the employer overnight. And it is the service condition is going to be completely changed. Baki Mr. Patak has told what is the BSNL's fate. And moreover, Raksha Mantri herself has announced there will be only 4 PSUs in the strategic sector. Defense is a strategic sector. You have already got 9 defense PSUs. And if this ordnance factory, if it become one corporation, then there will be 10 corporations. If it become 4 corporations, then there will be 13 corporations. Which 4 corporations will remain with the government of India and which will go to the private sector? Nobody knows. No reply so far. So therefore, the 3 genuine demands, whatever we have given to the government, are all reasonable demands. Please withdraw corporatization. ये देश का हित के लिए नहीं है. By corporatizing, you are killing a 219-year-old defense industry. It has come to the rescue of the government for the country whenever the country is in crisis. Right after the independence, I am not talking about First World War, Second World War, because Britishers were there. After freedom, if you go through the history of the ordnance factories and the commitment of the workforce night and day, 15 days, during Kargil crisis, these workers remained 15 days, 20 days, day and night. And latest, you see the COVID-19 period when the whole nation went on lockdown. It was the ordnance factory workers who worked day and night to produce personal protective equipments for the medical staff, doctors and whatnot. So therefore, the decision, and moreover, sir, moreover, it is a violation. Already they have violated, the government has violated the industrial dispute negotiation which is already pending before. They have also violated their own assurance given by 4 ministers. 4 defense ministers in the past, Mr. George Fernandez, late Pranab Mukherjee, Sri A.K. Antony, late Manohar Parikar. 4 ministers have given written assurance ordnance factories will not be corporatized. And the government has given a reply in the parliament, ordnance factory will not be corporatized. Now, in these circumstances, what was the necessity for the government taking advantage of the COVID-19 situation, violating everything, violating the pending negotiation, violating the previous assurances given by the Raksha Mantri, violating the assurance given before the parliament, violating their own stand before the parliamentary standing committee that ordnance factory should not be converted into a corporation? With all these things, arbitrarily taking such a decision, playing with the life of 80,000 permanent employees of this organization, changing their status, changing their life, and all are in deep distress. The entire ordnance factory workforce, right from DGOF to down below, all are in deep distress. So much so, as my president has mentioned, on the 31st of last month, the ordnance factory board convened a special board meeting. Okay, they cannot pass a resolution against corporatization like the unions, I can understand. But you please go through, it is an official minutes of the ordnance factory board, in which they have categorically mentioned If the ordnance factories is converted into a corporation, what will happen? What are all the implications? How the industry will be affected? Everything has been in detail analyzed critically by the ordnance factory board. It is also government. Ordnance factory board also is a government. They have conveyed everything to the Ministry of Defence, but without considering all these aspects. What forced the government to take this decision? None of our representations have been disposed of, and we have given an alternative suggestion. I will conclude with our alternative suggestion, because you asked Mr. Patak, what is your proposal? Our proposal is very simple, sir. As assured by the then Secretary DP in the negotiated settlement, that government has not taken any decision to corporatize the ordnance factories, that status quo ante has to be restored. Government has not taken any decision to corporatize ordnance factories. The written assurance, recorded minutes signed by Dr. Ajay Kumar, who is the present Defence Secretary. We have to go back to that position. We have to go back to that position. And in the same meeting, we have told 30,000 crore worth of production target. Please give us 5 years' time. Let the Ordnance Factory Board continue as a government department. We as the employees' representative assure the government that within 5 years, if the Ministry of Defence plays sufficient workload to the ordnance factories, we will reach 30,000 crore within 5 years in the government setup itself. In the meantime, appoint an expert committee. We are prepared to cooperate with the expert committee. Whatever improvement required in the structure, in the performance, in the productivity, in the autonomy, in the accountability, the federations are prepared to sit with that committee and settle. And third point, we are all appointed through an All India competitive examination through a selection process as a central government employee, as a defense employee. Many of us were working in public sector before joining this department. We left a public sector job and we joined a government job. Again, you are taking us back to the public sector against my appointment order. It is a appointment order is what? It is a contract between the President of India and me. That appointment order has been violated. You have given me an appointment order that I am recruited as a defense civilian employee in such and such post. And you are violating that agreement, that contract. Appointment is nothing but a contract. The Government of India is violating that agreement, and you are telling me from tomorrow onwards you are a public sector employee. What will happen to me? What will happen to my future? Where my family will go? Already 60% of the employees are in NPS system. No pension for them. We are fighting for their pension. So in this situation, abruptly, arbitrarily, without any logic, without any legal support, this is an unbiased, unfair labor practice adopted by the Department of Defense Production. They have to withdraw that. If they withdraw, as you have appealed, aam log bhi strike ko withdraw karenge. But if the government doesn't withdraw and expect only federation should withdraw the strike, that is not possible, because 99.9% of the employees have given a mandate through the strike ballot that don't accept corporatization, fight against corporatization. Therefore, CLC saab, hum aapko appeal karna chahta hun 80,000 employees ka taraf se. I am appealing you on behalf of the 80,000 employees. Please ask the Ministry of Defense not to adopt unfair labor practice, not to violate their own agreement, not to violate their own assurances. I am confident, since the Labor Ministry being the custodian of the working class of this country, you will take a proactive step to protect the interest of the working force working in the ordnance factories. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.